Dude, this is iPod Touch Style, and this is an iPod Touch Style review on Apple's iPod USB power adapter. The reason why I'm making this review is because I'm always sick of turning on my laptop and plugging my iPod in just to charge it. It's just a waste of time, and it makes me mad. So, what I did was I went out and purchased this at the Apple Store for $29.99. Warning, do not buy this at Radio Shack. They charge $40. They're insane. I know it's $10 more. It's a lot of money. Do not pay $40 for a stupid charger. For that much money, you can go out and buy yourself a PSP game or something like that. So, basically, I'm going to open this. It's already open. I reopened it before, but I put everything how it was in its original position. I'll be plugging it to my iPod Touch. And then plugging it into the wall and showing you it compared to an iMac or iBook power block. Not new. So, we'll open it up. Apple made a slide out. This box doubles as a case in a box, so it's nice and thick. Move that to the side. Here it is, nice and shiny. This only comes in white. All power blocks do, so don't be crying. Take that out. Okay. You get a nice thick USB wire. These are thicker than your other wires. First thing thickness is right here. The ones you get with your iPod Touch, which I have right here, is the iPod, are half the size of this. And they don't have the little buttons on the side. These are more for charging. They're thickened, so that's what I like about that, and the wire is a little thicker, so I'll be taking this out of the box. They come with little, two little connector plastic tips to protect the connector from any harm. Taking that out, and you get one right here, so let's see this. Okay, alright, we'll put these to the side. And you get your little instruction manual. Alright. Now that's to the side. Let's take a look at the power cube. It's nice. I like how this slides open. Easy access into the wall. It's nice. USB port. It's not like a little cheap, plastic, flimsy, little, you know, piece of garbage. It's nice. It's a little heavy. But not that heavy. Sturdy, if you drop it, it's not gonna break. You have a little, cutout here, if you want to change it to make a longer strip of wire, if it will reach to your wall. That's pretty cool. So let's put this together. And by the way, you can use your other USB adapter wire that came with your iPod. I recommend you use this. So we'll just plug this into the designated USB port on the back, right here. See if I can get a nice close shot for you guys to see that. Alright, that's good. Before I plug into my iPod and plug it into the wall, I'll be comparing it to this little guy. So you get the idea on how big this little thing is right here. Alright. So as you see, it's a big difference. Yeah. What you're seeing right here is an iBook power block. Quite big, very thick, twice the amount of weight, twice the size, less than half the amount of weight, less than half the size, does a quicker job. So you get that. If I wanted to, you could just switch these two. So if this wouldn't fit into my wall, I could just slide this out, and slide this out, and just switch the two, and this will fit right into my wall. But I'm never going to do that. I have no problems with it connecting to the wall. So, take a little moment and look at that. nice. Alright, so you basically get the point of how big that is. Move that on the side. And we're plugging this to the iPod, plugging it to the wall. Alright, so here's my iPod Touch. Right here. Here's the power adapter. Alright. This goes right into your iPod. Of course. Yeah. It's kind of hard to do with one hand, so just bear with me, please. Alright, I think I got it. Yep, there you go. No problem. Alright. So I'm gonna take this to the little power station I have. There you go. Plug it right in. Don't worry about my DS. And there we go. Simple as that. A really quick charge. You don't have to plug it into your computer. You don't have to turn your computer on. Simple as that. I recommend these. They're a great product. Thanks again. Please leave me comments and subscribe to my videos. Next, don't forget to check out my channels. I'll be making more videos on how to add ROMs to your iPod, how to make it install it quicker, some things you should download, how to download ROMs directly from your iPod, how to download music directly from your iPod, all that stuff. Oh, and I'll be showing you a little special video on how to organize your whole iTunes library. Organize it from your file, to the name, to the general, to everything. Exactly how you'll find it in iTunes. Even with the iTunes high-resolution album artwork. Perfectly. The tags and everything. So, that's great for you people that have iPod touches that are picky like me. And want to have every album artwork. And everything will be organized. So I'll be making that video. Subscribe. Check my channel for updates. I'll be posting a website soon. I have my friend helping me on that. It'll be a free webs. Right now it's under construction. But you can visit it. It's www.freewebs. F-R-E-E-W-E-B-S. .com/iPod Touch Style. That's iPodTouchStyle. Just like my name, iPod Touch Style. So go check that out. If that can be done, maybe until another month. I haven't even started on it yet. I just reserved the name. So, any suggestions you want me to add to the site? Any links? Maybe some ROM websites? Some special applications, and I'm working on a few themes, some really nice themes. I'll give you a little tip on a few of them. I'm going to have a nice theme, and it's going to be based on stuff that you guys all know. Y'all like it. So the first theme, I'll just tell you that one, it'll be an NBA theme, where it'll be called the Michael Jordan theme. It's a beautiful high-resolution theme with all of the logos for all the NBA players, Michael Jordan's number, a nice, beautiful slam dunk background of Michael Jordan slam dunking, and then the next one is going to be PS3 theme, which is going to be just like the XMB, and I'm going to adjust your iPod with a special little firmware thing. That I'm going to give you guys, it's not going to mess with your firmware, that's going to make your iPod just like the XMB bar on your PSPs and PS3s, so that's going to be really neat, just scrolling through and going through the categories and flipping something, so that's going to be done in a while, so just be patient with that, so let's check in, and hopefully sooner or later, I might open up PayPal, to get donations so I can buy a domain for a server from a installer so I could give you these guys from a direct upload to make easy. I'll be working on that as well. Alright, so thanks.